Sometimes you just gotta get away. When the concrete jungle gets a bit too much, it seems the open road is calling. Call it a feeling, a spirit. I call it my road religion, and it's calling Yukon Territories, Canada. Stiff in the big city of Vancouver, and for some reason, with 24 hours notice, I planned a trip to the Yukon. Call it crazy, call it irresponsible, I call it the quest for the open road. Truck and camper, I was ready for the open highway. After a quick goodbye, I was on my way.
So here I am, I'm off to the Yukon, and but they're not coming with me. And why aren't you coming with me?
Too long of a drive.
What, too long of a drive? It's only 2,600 kilometers.
We just found out.
Just found out? Okay. Well. Any last words of wisdom?
Be safe and don't drink and drive.
Yeah. Come back. Drive. I'll see you on
Tuesday.
Tuesday.
Use condoms.
Yeah. Condoms.
And drive careful.
The official leaving.
I'm gonna be like that guy. Okay, fuck you! Okay. Hello, this is Tom. My friend Andy is going on a really extraordinary journey. He's going to the Yukon. Now, listen, I'm from British Columbia. I've never been to the Yukon before. And I think this is gonna be very exciting for him and for me vicariously. I've lived in the West Coast, I've lived in the East Coast. But you know what? I gotta say, up north, Yukon ho!
It was clearly time to hit the road. My journey to the Yukon from Vancouver would take us through Dawson Creek. From there, we'll follow the Alaska Highway, or Alcan Highway, to Whitehorse, Yukon, Canada. Well, I drank a little bit too much with my neighbors over there. They're locals from Chetwynd. Nice people, really good people. Playing beer games to the wee hours. But I had a shower in the rig, and I want to show you folks what I just woke up to. I want everybody to meet Casper. Now, the reason I have called him Casper is because he's white. And he's a bit spooky on certain corners. When that load starts shifting on really bad corners, spooky. This is Casper. Casper's been good to me. And Casper's gonna stay being good to me. Because we got a lot of road to make. We're almost on the Alcan Highway, and it's gonna be a great day. It's gonna be 23 degrees today.
There's a road that lies under northern skies toward the land of the midnight sun. It crosses the crest of the great northwest, and it's known as the Alcan Run.
Alaska was brought closer to us with the building of the Alaska Highway in 1942. Built with the cooperation of our Canadian neighbors, this famous highway connects with the Canadian roads at Dawson Creek, thus completing the first land route between Alaska and our other states. From Dawson Creek, it is a 1,500-mile drive to the end of the highway in Fairbanks, Alaska. Building the Alaska Highway was one of the great engineering jobs of our time. Men had to cut the road through the forest wilderness and build it up over the soft, swampy ground called muskeg. The road stretches across beautiful, rugged country that is sometimes called America's last frontier. Terminus of the highway is Fairbanks.
Highway, baby. Wow. It's fantastic. Look at this day. It's going to be 24 degrees. We have blue sky. The birds are singing. This is awesome. Not bad for mid-May, Alaska Highway. Fantastic. This is a wonderful example of the old Alaska Highway to your right and the new highway to your left. The old highway was notorious for wandering in and out, and in fact today's modern highway is shorter. A couple minutes ago when I was I was setting up over on the old Alaska Highway, on the old asphalt of Alaska Highway, and I swear I hear a bear just in the wilderness over there, making some weird grunting sounds. So I don't think I'm going to go too close to the forest right now. And hopefully if he does come out, I'll maybe get a good shot of him. But yeah, this is a great example. Old highway, new highway. And I guess with a little bit of time, the old Alaska Highway is slowly going back to the forest. At the 500 kilometer mark on the Alaska Highway, and I can't say enough about this weather. It's absolutely amazing. It's about 24 degrees. I'm 20 miles north of Fort Nelson. And the bugs are alive, the birds are chirping, the sky is blue. This is amazing. You know, right now, when there was an internet connection in Fort Nelson, I looked, and right now Los Angeles is 17 degrees. Fort Nelson, northern BC, on the Alaska Highway, it's 24. Vancouver is 13 degrees Celsius. Not bad. I got very lucky, but all the credit goes to Mother Nature, because it's absolutely amazing. Anybody who dreams about the Yukon or Alaska, the Alaska Highway, the Alcan Highway, whatever you call it, whatever you call it, you need to come up here. Now we just passed Summit Lake, and the mosquitoes are out, it's still 12 degrees, and it's fantastic. This is what I'm talking about when it comes to the Yukon and the Alaska Highway. Take a look at this. It's gorgeous, it's perfect, it's rugged, and it's yours if you want to come up here and see it. We'll be right back.
My name's Dan Clements. I live right here at Toad River. I built this aircraft. It took me about 5 years. I just did it in the winter time. I had about 1 to 2 months each winter, and 99 was the first time I flew it. And I think I've got about 825 hours on it right now. So it's been working real well for me. Wow. Now I got the grandkids.
Tell me what kind of plane this is.
It's called an RV-6. They were designed and built out of Portland, Oregon, Vans Aircraft.
Man, today was an amazing day. I met some good people, started my day out right next to a lake, saw moose, bear, caribou. Yeah, it was an amazing day. Tomorrow I'm hoping it's going to be just as good. I'm ending my day tonight with a nice steak, which I'm about to enjoy. And I'm in Muncho Lake Provincial Park, and tomorrow I'm going to hit Liard Hot Springs and Watson Lake, and it's going to be a great day. Tomorrow is going to be fantastic. So here I am in my home away from home. Does it get better than this? I don't think so. I knew I was actually going to see some buffalo up here because all along the highway, just before Liard Hot Springs, there are these huge little round piles of poop. Now, you don't have to be a zoologist to figure out that whatever poops that big has to be big. And yeah, look for the signs. As you can tell from this shot, I'm at least 300 or 400 feet away from these buffalo. And you want to make sure you maintain a nice safe distance from these animals. So make sure you bring a nice camera, look, watch. Don't get too close, folks. It's dangerous. Don't risk the life of the animal or your own life by getting too close. These are very big, powerful animals. Maintain your distance. Thank you. Welcome to lunchtime in Liard Hot Springs. On today's menu, hot dogs. Yum, yum, yum. Does it get better than this? After my wonderful dip in Liard Hot Springs, oh man, I'm telling you, that is pure heaven. Liard Hot Springs, wow. You know, the workers who built the Alaska Highway, actually, the ones that were posted building this section of the road were the lucky ones because they got to swim in those pristine hot waters during the cold winters. Coming up just down the road, we're going to be hitting the Yukon, British Columbia border, and Watson Lake. Strong and free, baby. Yukon ho. I'm here. And it's gorgeous. It's just after lunchtime, and there isn't a soul around. It's 18 degrees. As you can tell, I'm wearing a t-shirt. I should actually be wearing shorts. I've got my sunglasses on because it's actually very bright out. It's going to be a great day. Watson Lake's coming up.
suggest that these people live in Hazard. I'd like to live in Hazard County. I had a great trip. Look at the weather. It's been fantastic. I could not ask for more. Here comes that one car. Watch the car go by. There they go. There's about one car every 1 to 6 minutes, maybe. And this is the busy stretch, I guess. Hello, it's 8:30 and I'm here at the SS Klondike in downtown Whitehorse. It's a beautiful day, it's still probably about 15. I actually don't need the fleece. Everybody's walking and rollerblading and people are walking along the Yukon River right now. It's a wonderful evening. Love what they've done with the Klondike. I toured that when I was a kid. Beautiful boat, little piece of history here. If you ever come to Whitehorse, you gotta take the tour. I'm gonna buzz around Whitehorse right now and see the rest of the I'm gonna see the rest of the place. Thank you.
Thank you.